Thank you. The academic procession is about to enter the auditorium. Would you please stand? Please remain standing for the national anthem. The words are on page 6 of your program. Please be seated. Whoops. It is my pleasure to introduce the presiding officer of this evening's ceremony and member of the Council of Swinburne University of Technology, Councillor David Einan.
Deputy Vice-Chancellor, members of the University Council, members of staff, distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen. It is with pleasure that I welcome you all to this graduation ceremony, which acknowledges the achievements of so many of you and which represents a significant step in the process of lifelong learning. As a mark of respect to Australia's Indigenous people, Swinburne University of Technology acknowledges the Wurundjeri people as the traditional custodians of the land where we now meet to conduct this graduation ceremony. On the occasion of this graduation ceremony, the council and staff wish to share their pride and congratulations with the graduates on their achievement. For all of us, it marks a very special occasion. For the graduates, it means the culmination of years of study, hard work and achievement. For the parents, family and friends of the graduates, it means that all the sacrifices you have made and the support you have provided to the graduating member of your family have finally been rewarded. There is now happiness in seeing your friend or family member succeed. We are pleased that so many of you have been able to make this such a special occasion. For the academic and administrative staff of the university, there is satisfaction in seeing students successfully complete their studies. This is an important occasion for the university also. It gives a public profile to Swinburne's ongoing commitment to provide opportunities to students to pursue a range of educational qualifications, which will assist them in making an ongoing contribution to the community in which they choose to reside. Swinburne is committed to being both a national and internationally recognised institution in which the educational curriculum is structured so as to be relevant to the international community as well as to Australia. I now call upon the Deputy Vice-Chancellor Higher Education, Professor Dale Murphy, to introduce this evening's guest speaker.
Councillor, it is with pleasure that I introduce Mr. Mark Sturgis. Mark is currently General Manager, Network Services for City Power Proprietary and Power Corp Australia Limited. These two Victorian companies, combined with their sister company, ETSA Utilities, form the largest electricity distribution network business in Australia. They are also part of the $11 billion of Australian investments of the Hong Kong-based Chung Kong Group, which is globally has a market capitalisation of $114 billion and operates in 50 countries with over 200,000 employees. Mark has over 30 years' experience in leading large service operations for both private and government organisations. He is passionate about leadership and in particular about the opportunities that come through innovative thinking, dynamic leadership and a strong educational foundation. Mark is an Associate Fellow of the Australian Institute of Management, co-founder of PowerCore's 8th Gate Innovation Incubator, and is on several advisory boards, including Swinburne's Australian Graduate School of Entrepreneurship Course Advisory Committee for the Master of Business Administration. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that I invite Mr. Mark Sturgis to deliver this evening's occasional address.
Welcome everyone and thank you very much for the opportunity to be part of the ceremony tonight. And I'd like to thank obviously councillors, the Deputy Vice-Chancellor, the Deputy Dean and all other special guests and members of the academic staff here tonight. I guess tonight is really about a celebration in my mind, and what I'd like to do is for 5 or 10 minutes just reflect I think on the journey that you've been through and perhaps some insights into where that might take you in the future. I guess from my point of view and having been in the same position, it's certainly been a journey I guess for many of you where you've actually had to move from your home country, you've come to Australia. For many others you've had to move away from family or you've been in some respects detached from your workplace, and others you're aspiring to get into the workforce in your first role. So I guess the first point I'd make is it's certainly been a journey. I guess the second point I'd like to make is no doubt it's been hard work and a lot of commitment. And I, again, from personal experience and having worked for a long time in industry, know that it's typically hard work and perseverance that gets us the results. It's less about academic brilliance, but you put those two things together and you're really on a winner. I guess the next point I'd make is that we've relied very much, no doubt, on support from our partners, from our families, often from our businesses, and sometimes from our communities. So from that point of view, the journey has relied on a lot of support. And I know for some of you, you will have faced the risk of failure. In going into this particular course, many of you will have felt, can I get through this program? What happens if I fail? So for many of you, you've confronted risk and the potential for failure, and you've come through that. Also, I guess diversity is an issue, and many of us, as I said, will have come from different backgrounds, different countries. So diversity and the mix of cultural mix and diversity of people within the course and the course structure and the different faculties and the different courses will have given you a rich experience, I'm sure. And if I use the example of my own company, PowerCore Australia and City Power, if you think about my companies, we're only 10 years old and we've had four owners. We were initially owned by the Victorian government. We were then owned by the Americans. We were then owned by the Scots. We're now owned by the Chinese. And that's all in 10 years. So you can imagine the diversity of input that's come from those different cultures and different styles of management and ownership. But I guess out of all of this, what I'd like to propose to you is that tonight, or what tonight represents, will in fact be a very defining moment in your lives. You may not yet realise it, but I'll guarantee you when you look back on this particular ceremony and the award that you've achieved, this will be a defining moment in your life. Now, what do I mean by defining moment? Well, it's my belief that probably in our lives there's only four to six, maybe a couple more, but there's only really a handful of defining moments that actually set us on a new course, or are moments in our life that probably are the catalyst for all that we think, all that we achieve, and all that we aspire to. And again, I'd be proposing that the efforts you've put in and your achievements represented here tonight will certainly be defining moments in your careers. Now, I'd like just briefly to give you two brief stories of people that are close to me that I think it's been this particular sort of event has been a defining moment for them, and I'll give you two examples. Now, the first one is a guy that works for me. He's 63 years old, and a couple of years ago he came to me and said, look, you know, I think my career's passing me by, I think the company's passing me by, no one's listening to my ideas anymore, I don't seem to have any influence, and yet I think I've still got something to offer. So after a long discussion, we worked out that what he really needed to do was go back to school. So he actually enrolled here at Swinburne, doing the Masters of Entrepreneurship. And he went through all those fears, you know, will I be accepted in the course? I haven't actually been back to school for 40 years in his case. 40 years. How will he go in terms of getting through the course, etc.? And, you know, will it take him away from work and family? And he got through all those barriers and hurdles. He enrolled, he was accepted by Swinburne, and he's gone on from strength to strength. He got through the first part of the course with flying colours, and in terms of his contribution back in the workplace, he's never been so productive, he's never been so energised, and now he sees a future in the company for him. And the company's getting the benefit for that support. Now, the second story, very briefly, is a woman who, at a very young age, was estranged from her family. She was forced to leave school in her early teens. And to be honest, she went off the rails. Fortunately, she met a guy who gave her support and she picked herself up. And over the last 10 to 15 years has had a wonderful family, is now a partner in a very successful consulting business. And in fact, tomorrow night I've been invited to a dinner party to celebrate her achievement of the success of gaining her first degree. Now, she's 45 years old. She's very excited about this, and clearly the achievement of this degree, her degree, is a defining moment in her life. So I guess just pushing forward now and putting the onus back on all of you, the graduates, you know, whether you're an MBA, whether you're an MEI student, whether you're doing a doctorate, whatever, whether you're doing accounting, or whether you're doing a graduate certificate, or whether you've achieved that, what I'd be asking you to do is think about the journey ahead. And many of you will see this, and I'm sure, as the catalyst. And I'll give you a few four examples. For the MEI students, tonight really, or what is represented here tonight, may well be the start of a new business for you. So a new business startup. For doctoral graduates, I'm sure, you know, what about that groundbreaking research that's required by our country and by the world? I'm sure you're up to it in terms of the particular journey that you might take on as part of that. And, you know, what about the HR students are you going to go out there and are you going to give leadership and support to workforces? You know, there are so many opportunities that all of you are going to have in moving forward. And so I guess, really, let's just reflect on a couple of things. And I think the first thing is the support we've been given by our companies, in some cases by our friends, by our families, by our partners and by the academic staff. And this is not rehearsed, but what I'm going to ask all the graduates to do is actually to stand up now, to face back to your supporters and give them a rounding applause and a cheer for the work they've done for you. So could you please all stand up, turn around, face, and let's say thanks to all those people that support us. Well done, thank you very much, and you can be seated again. Now, just in wrapping up, because I know I stand between you and your academic achievements tonight, let's use tonight as the catalyst. Let's celebrate our awards collectively. Let's be passionate. Let's embrace the cultural diversity that's been brought together in this group here. Let's certainly not forget about life and its learning and the journey that goes with it. And let's combine some of the academic brilliance we have here with a lot of hard work and persistence, because that's what we need in this country. And for those of you that are thinking about your first job, and I'm sure there'll be a number of you here that are either about to break into the workforce or have just broken into the workforce, don't panic if that first job is not the right one. It's a journey. If it's not, move on to the next one. But keep persevering until you find your niche. So I guess my final challenge to you all tonight is, will your award be a defining moment in your career, in your life? Are you willing to persist in the face of adversity? Are you willing to try different things? And I guess, are you willing to help those that are perhaps not quite necessarily as successful, but perhaps as fortunate, and sometimes those that haven't quite been ready to take that next step, someone that needs a support or a mentor. And in the case of the two stories I told you about earlier tonight, both of those people connected with people that supported them at a very defining moment in their lives. So with that, can I congratulate you all. It's a wonderful achievement. You've done wonderfully well. Use it wisely. And have a great night. Thank you very much.
Thanks very much, Mike, for those encouraging words, and I'm sure they're well appreciated. You've stolen part of my script because I was going to have them turn around later in the evening. But would you come forward and accept a small gift as appreciation for making the time to come tonight. Thanks very much. Thank I now call upon the Director of Student Operations, Ms. Toni Kilsby, to verify that the graduates listed in the program are eligible to receive their awards.
Councillor, I have the honour to inform you that in accordance with Statute 13 of Swinburne University of Technology, the graduates who will be presented at this ceremony or who have applied to have their award conferred in absentia have fulfilled the conditions prescribed and are entitled to the award of Bachelor Degree, Graduate Certificate, Graduate Diploma, Master, Master Honours Degree or Doctor of Philosophy as appropriate of Swinburne University of Technology.
Would all graduates please stand? By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Council of Swinburne University of Technology, I admit the duly authorised graduates here present and in absentia to the appropriate awards and to the rights and privileges of those awards. Congratulations. Please be seated. I now call on the Deputy Dean of the Faculty of Business and Enterprise, Associate Professor Patricia Buckley, to present her graduates.
Councillor, I have the honour to present to you the graduates on whom you have conferred the degree of Bachelor. For the Bachelor of Business, Scott Anthony Belling. Luke Joseph Brady. Zoe Bree Cargill. Sasira Chotti Pritcherat. Benita Damania. Ki-Ming Dori. Maria Gao. Penelope Rose Gear. Gary Gravina. Firas Muhammad Ibrahim Hamid. Nicole Hansen. Irene Harina. Ileana Binte Ilias. Iskander. Sylvie Giunianti. Andrew Stephen Kinross. Kane William Law. Kay Lee. Kelly Patricia McDonough. Tanya Robin McLaren. Jan Wei Un. Dale William Parsons. Nicola Olivia Paul. And Gage Suluchana Panima Pereira. Olivia Ann Potter. Chair Kiao. David Paul Rankin. Kiara Lisa Sarko. Ya Ling Su. Sharon May Lin Ting. Marie Alison Teofilo. Nia Trang T. Tran. Renee Danielle Willis. Hai Bo Su. Yung Yang Yap. And for the Bachelor of Business and the Bachelor of Arts in Italian, Luisa Rose Barbaro. Anita Bortolotto. Daniel Canizzo. Daniela, I apologise. Robert Kozlovic. Paul Daniel. Jessica Ingrosso. Vince Lepre. Angela Louisa Lee Rossi. Rebecca Ann Lyons. Stefano Mario Martini. Christy Pinto. Richard Roderick Schmidt. Matthew Vaccaro. For the Bachelor of Business and the Bachelor of Arts in Japanese, Claire Louise Biggs. Melinda Ann Frank. Zoe Lara Gaylard. Jennifer Susan Hogan. Mithun Mukherjee. Melinda Jane Newitt. Christine Pistofian. Matthew Jane Stennett Thorne. Jacqueline Monica Yates. And for the Bachelor of Business in Accounting, Abia Aluni. Catherine Jane Allen. Ye Fu Bai. Lauren Ellen Baldwin. Erin Jane Brown. Wing Pong Chung. Enna Chow. Wai Ho Chung. Priyantha Ramani Dhirasundara. Shun Fun. Michelle Yang. Ryan John Holland. Hui Jun Zhao. Banyut Joy Kum. Sailor Kadrick. Saith Karakok. Iwona Maria Karpowitz. Humdi Abdod Gafu Khalil. Hawa Twitkar. Lily Anna Kola. Angie Katrulis. Terence Kwan Yan Leong. Benjamin Ashley Lethborg. Michael Lee. Hua Hui Lee. Joanne Patricia Lilly. Min Lin. Robin Tracy McKenzie. Joanne Elizabeth Monk. Clarence Moyo. Tao Tu Win. Cameron Anthony Pepper. Unity Mugov Polisi. Christy Marie Robertson. Shi Shin. Monique J. Somerville. Fiona Nicole Stanley. Kia Wang. Wen Sheng. For the Bachelor of Business in Human Resource Management, Elizabeth Ann Collier. Jennifer Ann Dove. Carla Ellen Hanlon. Annette Louise Helmond. Yu Ho Hong Ray. Bianca Lee Holland. Crystal Rose Lum. Shabana Nazim Mohammed. Yvonne Hee Gok Ong. Lauren Ann Sullivan. Laura Eileen Thompson. Shara Ann Wade. For the Bachelor of Business in International Business, Matthew Gerard Elsley. Lauren Olivia Natalie Pellew. Andrew Stewart Winters. For the Bachelor of Business in International Business and the Bachelor of Arts in Italian, Sarah Claire Chenoweth. For the Bachelor of Business in Marketing, Christina Michelle Bond. Dominique Nicole Caratelli. Mary Rose Cruz. Catherine Louise Howley. Rebecca Tina Ivanov. Daniel Paul Lawrence. Liam Martin Murphy. Schaefer John Stewart. Stephanie Hui Lu Tan. For the Bachelor of Business Honours with Lower Second Class Honours, Christine Connie Colombo. With Upper Second Class Honours, Matthew Stephen Drew. Trent Jonathan Prestigar. Councillor, I have the honour to present to you the graduates to whom you have awarded a graduate certificate. For the Graduate Certificate of Accounting, John Vasiliadis. For the Graduate Certificate of Business in International Business, Justin Francis Ross MacDonald. Councillor, I have the honour to present to you the graduates to whom you have awarded a graduate diploma. For the Graduate Diploma of Business in Human Resource Management, Christine Margaret Bombinski. Ingrid Jane Carpenter. Ewan Rhys Carter. Kylie Ann Chambers. Brenda Margaret Lowe. Matthew Robert Parker. Buddy Lee Veerstegen. Ivica Vukasinovic. For the Graduate Diploma of Business in Marketing, Sally Ann Bodman. Rebecca Deanne Dick. Councillor, I have the honour to present to you the graduates on whom you have conferred the degree of Master. For the Master of Accounting, Amir Sawa Arsan. Amanda Nicole Bird. Jim Bukos. Arti Bandu. Anna Maria Buzescu. Katapati Kangan Amgi Samson Dios. Jennifer Ann Draper. Azia Palakai Fili Iha. Amrith Dev Jusbrut. Frank Fotios Koutsoubos. Octaria Kerniawati. Hung Tu T. Lay. Wen Hui Lee. Rosita Dioyo Matono. Jose Leopoldo Morales Fernandez. Yana Pavlovskaya. Sophie Petridis. Hemant Rowe. Kumaraku Kuparan Somasundram. Paul John Tui Ninga. Yi Ran Wang. Shen Wang. Jeffrey Charles Weber. Donna Marissa Wirasubrata. Lynn Scher. For the Master of Business Administration, Sandy Abram. Francesco Luke Alessio. Ronald Martin Alexi. Laurel Margaret Atkinson. Benjamin Campbell. Stephen Kenneth Drummy. Anthony John Green. Emma Noel Haraktasis. Dinesh Harvard. Timothy Joseph Inkster. Garan Yanyos. Shelley King. Vincent Rex King. Robert William Lewis. Sean Donald McLean. Grain Oates. Jim Papazoglou. George Polydoros. Brett Gerard Poulton. Jason Paul Preble. Daniel Michael Prince. Alex Ashley Terafi. Paul Joseph Tierney. Tim Wagg. Mark Walker. For the Master of Business in Human Resource Management, John Brennan. Bradley Sean Caverhill. Georgina Dale. Natalie Jane Dixon. Kirsten Lee Eagles. William Martin Hardy. Meredith Joan Hill. Leslie Catherine Jane Carantonis. Kirsten Elizabeth Mole. Greg Daniel Murray. Anthony Perkin. David Alexander Sanderson. Anthony Matthew Wheel. For the Master of Business in Marketing, Rosalind Marie Boys. Gregory Roger Goff. David William Hilgerman. Bernard William Hughes. Stephen Thomas Lynch. Wahida Roshan. David John Wheeler. For the Master of Entrepreneurship and Innovation, Michael John Butko. Robert Ciccioni. Yeah. Nathan Craze. David Jeffrey Herbert. Michael Ralph Johnson. Carly Moppet. Michael Savalieve. Paniotis Skeliotis. E. Lin Sho. And John Anthony Van Wissen. For the Master of Science in Strategic Foresight, James Stewart Gillespie. Neil John Horton. Angela Teresa Helena Masters. Rowena Stacey Murrow. Ian Kenneth Wood. For the Master of Accounting Honours, Jennifer Susan Thompson. For the Master of Business Administration Honours, Graham Cullen Bond. Thelina Naveen Garug. Pamela Doris Passaz. Sarah Jane Rungi. Councillor, I have the honour to present to you the graduates on whom you have conferred the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. For the Doctor of Philosophy, Wendy Robin Harding. The title of Wendy's thesis is Intersubjectivity and Large Groups, a Systems Psychodynamic Perspective. Wendy studied in depth the dynamics of three large groups. The analysis integrated insights gained through both system psychodynamic theory and intersubjective theory, here brought together for the first time in relation to this subject. The research showed the importance of mutual recognition between the individual and the large group, without which the individual is unable to reach their potential as a group member and the person and the group function suboptimally. The large undifferentiated group exists at a psychosocial level in all large organisations, even when the organisation is highly structured into smaller subsystems. Hence, the research findings are widely applicable. Councillor, I present to you Dr. Wendy Robin Harding for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Councillor, the next graduate on whom you have conferred the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is Ghassan Ghas Hozari. Ghassan's thesis title is A Ratio-Based Multi-Level Modelling Approach for Signalling Corporate Collapse, a Study of Australian Corporations. This study exploited a new methodological breakthrough called Multi-Level Modelling for Signalling Corporate Collapse. The procedure relied on financial ratios in order to identify problem areas threatening the financial integrity of a corporation. MLM was tested against multiple discriminant analysis, which is considered the mainstream methodological approach for signalling corporate collapse. The tests were carried out on a sample of Australian publicly listed corporations during the period 1989 to 2002. The results demonstrated that MLM is superior to MDA in signalling collapse. MLM generated better overall predictive power and dramatically reduced the possibility of misclassifying a collapse company. Councillor, I present to you Dr. Ghassan Gus Hazari for the Director of Doctoral Philosophy. Councillor, the next graduate on whom you have conferred the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is Con Krios. The title of Con's thesis is An Exploratory Case Study of Internal Service Quality in a Telecommunications Organisation, a Frontline Employee Perspective. A case study approach was undertaken to investigate internal service quality issues that related to the frontline employee role in a telecommunications organisation's call centres. The results showed that while all internal services identified shared some similarities in their demand characteristics, some groups of internal services were distinctly different to others in terms of frontline employees' needs, thereby allowing four classification categories to emerge. Results also indicated that frontline employees perceived some internal services as more important than others in terms of increasing their ability to generate revenue, which presented implications for managers in terms of allocating organisational resources. Councillor, I present to you Dr. Con Krios for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Councillor, the next graduate on whom you have conferred the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is Ravindranath Nayak. Ravindranath's thesis title is Developing Sustainable Corporations in Australia. This study examined how to enhance organisational value by sustainable business practices. It considered the two dominant strategic management theories, that is, barriers to entry theory and the resource-based view theory. The data was collected from 102 Australian business organisations using a survey method. Based on its findings, this study attempts to identify when and how social-oriented and environment-oriented business practices can be effective or least effective strategically. Furthermore, this study substantiates that a business organisation can enhance its competitive advantage by pursuing corporate sustainability principles. It upholds the view that business organisations have enlightened self-interest in following corporate sustainability. Councillor, I present to you Dr. Ravindranath Nayak for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Councillor, that concludes the presentation of awards this evening. I now call upon the Deputy Vice-Chancellor, Higher Education Division, Professor Dale Murphy, to present the 2006 Sir Rupert Hamer Postgraduate Scholarship.
Councillor. In 1996, Swinburne University of Technology, together with the Australia Day Committee of Victoria, established an annual scholarship to the value of $5,000 to assist postgraduate students to fulfil their academic goals. In 2001, the Australia Day Scholarship was renamed the Sir Rupert Hamer Postgraduate Scholarship in honour of the late Sir Rupert Hamer's long and distinguished contribution to community service. This award also recognises Sir Rupert Hamer's family association with Swinburne University of Technology as the nephew of the university's founder, George Swinburne. Sir Rupert Hamer is greatly missed by the Swinburne community. Selection for this scholarship is based on sound academic record and evidence of significant and sustained contribution to community affairs. The winner of the Sir Rupert Hamer Postgraduate Scholarship for 2006 is Loredana Mihailia Tilia. Loredana commenced her studies at Swinburne in 2002 when she began work towards the degree of Bachelor of Social Science in Psychology and Social Statistics. Loredana has made contributions to migrant communities and to the young through involvement with several community organisations over several years, in particular with the City of Greater Dandenong Some Nation Festival. Her aim is to assist young people with their social and wellbeing development. This year, Loredana is continuing her studies in the Postgraduate Diploma of Psychology in the Faculty of Life and Social Sciences. I am pleased to present to you Loredana Tilia as the recipient of the Sir Rupert Hamer Postgraduate Scholarship for 2006. I now call upon Ms. Joanne Lilly, who graduated this evening with a Bachelor of Business in Accounting, to speak on behalf of the graduates.
Members of Council, Deputy Vice Chancellor, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I would first like to thank Swinburne for giving me this opportunity to thank and acknowledge those people who have helped all of us, the students, achieve what we have here today. On behalf of the students graduating this evening, I would like to thank the staff of the university for their friendly assistance, support and guidance that they have provided us throughout the years of our studies. We appreciate all that you have done for us, especially giving us that time that we know you always didn't have. The experience of studying at Swinburne has been the most enjoyable, rewarding and memorable, and we will take with us many skills, learning experiences that will assist us in our future endeavours. For all of us, this is a very proud moment and something we have worked towards for a very long time. It's something sometimes been hard and we have lost focus, but we never lost sight of our long-term goal. All we can say now is we're here and we did it. I would now like to take this opportunity to thank, most importantly, all our families and friends for their support during our years of study. You have been there from the beginning, you have shared the same goals, and you have kept us focused, so thank you. This is just as much your day as it is ours. And finally, to all of us here today, may we have every success in whatever we do now, whether it be developing a career or continuing with our studies. Whatever we go on to do, I'm sure the knowledge and experience we've gained during our studies will help us whichever path we choose. Well done and good luck.
Thanks very much, Joanne. To Swinburne graduates, I know that today is the culmination of years of hard work, and that during that time you have had the encouragement and help of family and friends, and so many of whom have come from many parts of Australia and indeed in some cases from around the world to see you graduate. On yours and the university's behalf, I wish to thank them for their support of your studies at Swinburne. I'm sure they, like you, are very proud of what you have achieved. I would also like to thank the academic and administrative staff for their contribution to your education at Swinburne. Would all of the academic and administrative staff please rise? Graduates, please join me in expressing your appreciation to them for their efforts. I'd also like to take this opportunity to make mention of Swinburne Careers and Employment. who offer a range of careers and employment services free of charge to all Swinburne graduates and higher education graduates of up to 2 years' standing. I trust that you will consider this to be the beginning of a lifelong association with Swinburne. Education is a continuing process, and I hope that many of you will return to further your studies and to participate in the activities of the Swinburne Alumni Association. The Alumni Association has groups in many parts of the world who organise a range of local events, so even if you're leaving Melbourne, that does not mean an end to your participation in Swinburne activities. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of all members of Swinburne, congratulations to all those who've received awards this evening.
That concludes the formal part of this ceremony. On behalf of the members of council and the university community, I would like to invite you to join us for refreshments, which will be served in the Parkview Room directly behind the auditorium. Would you now please stand while the official party, academic procession, and procession of graduates leaves the auditorium? Thank you.
Thank you.